My name is Saul. I'm 7 years old. And I am going to read The Fight for Atlantis. Atlantis is a sunken city in the Mediterranean Sea. Atlantis is populated by monsters and other sea creatures. Atlantis has lots of treasure, jewels, gold, and other precious things. Some of the creatures live in caves, and others live in the sunken ruins of temples. Atlantis used to be a city where demigods lived. They were the children of Poseidon. One day, Poseidon went to sleep, and when he woke, he saw all his children acting like mortals, stealing, cheating, and other bad behavior. So he sent a curse to them and burned the city of Atlantis and sunk it to the bottom of the sea. And when the city sank, the demigods changed into sea creatures over time. And then most of the sea creatures eventually turned into monsters. Now there are different species of monsters who live in Atlantis. There are three monster guardians, the short guardian and two who live in the portal of Atlantis. The portal of Atlantis is the gates to Atlantis. The short guardian is the biggest guardian and one of the biggest monsters. He looks like a shark and has 10 main teeth in his jaws and spikes coming out of his sides. He guards certain parts of Atlantis. The front of the portal of Atlantis is a large monster's head that opens to allow any monster to pass through. Once inside, there is a staircase that leads up to the place where all the powers are stored. In front of these powers, there is a gate that's wide open for monsters, but remains shut for any other species. The two guardians patrol the area above where the power is stored. On one side of the portal is a dungeon, and on the other is an armory. Now humans are having a problem with these monsters at Atlantis. They are rising to the surface and stealing treasure from the humans. The monsters are also taking over some towns. In fact, these monsters are trying to take over the world, and the humans have decided to fight back. These are the two sides in the fight for Atlantis. To be continued.